In the Bhagavad Gita, it is said, Bhumi Rapanala Vayu Khangamano Buddhiri Vasa Vindami Pratiti Yastadha. These materialistic persons, scientists, physicists, and other speculators, they are dealing with these elements, materials. Earth, water, fire, air, ether, up to mind, cycle. All little advanced intelligence, but no more. They are dealing in their university, colleges, educational institutions. They are concerned with these elements, material. They have no spiritual knowledge. Krishna says, we get information from the Bhagavad Gita, aparayam, these eight elements, they are inferior. Therefore, because they are dealing with this inferior nature only, their knowledge is inferior. This is a fact. It is not that I am accusing, no. They have no information. Big professor, they say, this is body finish. Body finish means panchatta prapt. They do not know that there is another body, subtle body, mind, intelligence, ego. They do not. They are thinking this earth, water, air, fire, ether, that much. This is finished, I see. Either you burn the body or bury the body, finish everything, finish, and various other things. So they have no knowledge. So they have no knowledge even of the subtle body, earth, water, which carries the soul. And what they know about the soul? So, Krishna gives information in the Bhagavad Gita, aparayam, these elements, even up to mind, intelligence, ego, bhinna, they are mind-separated energy. Separated energy. And aparayam, this is inferior. And there is another, superior. Aparayam itastu vidhimi prakritim para. Para means superior. Now, they may be asking, what is that? We know these elements only. What is that? Another superior. Jiva bhuta mahava. Clearly said, that is living. And they are thinking that there is no other superior energy except these eight material elements, or five elements, therefore they are in ignorance. It is for the first time they are getting some knowledge. Bhagavad Gita as it is, and from that we can know that there is another superior energy, which is Jiva Bhuta, the living entity which is moving the body, that is superior energy. So they have no information, neither there is an attempt to understand the superior energy in their universities or institutions. Therefore they are murah. They may be very much puffed up of their so-called knowledge, but according to Vedic knowledge, they are mudhas. And if one cannot understand the superior energy, prakriti, nature, then how one can understand God? That is not possible. Then again, dealings between God and the superior energy, that is bhakti. It is very difficult. Manushyanam sahasresu kaschit jatati siddhaye. The siddhaye means to understand that superior element, that is siddhi. And after that, one can understand Krishna. That is very difficult, especially in this age, mandasumandamatayo. Manda means they are not interested, or even they are little interested, they are very slow. They do not understand. This is the prime knowledge. And first of all, we must know it. Athāta brahma jigyāsa, that superior knowledge. That is required. But everyone is neglected. There is no inquisitiveness even. What is that thing which is moving this body? There is no inquiry. They think automatically by combination of this matter, they are still persisting on this point. And when you challenge, you take this chemical and prepare the living force, they will say, that I cannot do. If you cannot do, then why you are speaking like nonsense, that the combination of matter of chemicals gives the life? You take the chemical. Our doctor, Sarup Damodar, in the California University, one big professor came to lecture on chemical evolution, and he challenged immediately, if I give you the chemicals, can you produce life? He said, that I cannot. So, this is their position. They cannot prove it, they cannot do it.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.